NMF. It could stand for not my fault, no more flamingos, or never marry Frank. But because this is a channel where on occasion we talk about skin, it stands for natural moisturizing factor. Charles Vick, you asked what NMF is, and we, the royal we, like you and I, are gonna give him an answer. NMF is your skin's naturally occurring moisturizer. It's a soup full of super efficient humectants that attract moisture to your skin. You can find them here in the outer layer of the stratum corneum, packaged inside our corneocytes, which are our dead skin cells. If you check out this snazzy graph, you'll see that NMFs are mostly made up of free amino acids and the products of their breakdown. I'm talking about PCA, uricanic acid, inorganic salts, sugars, even lactic acid, and urea. How much do we have? NMF makes up about 10% of the mass of our corneocytes and about 20 to 30% of the dry weight of the stratum corneum. We like NMF. No, actually, we love it because it increases the elasticity of the stratum corneum. Hey, us humans love skin that looks good and feels soft and supple. NMF does this by interacting with the keratin fibers so they become more flexible. The highly efficient humectants in NMF, they suck the water right out of the atmosphere and draw them into our corneocytes. This process can happen in really dry environments with humidity as low as 50%. So you stay moisturized even in the harshest conditions. Now, if you're like me before I did this video, you may have thought dead skin cells were a barren wasteland. Although the corneocytes are biologically dead, biochemically, they're actually very active. There are a number of enzymes in corneocytes, and they require water to perform their duties. They need NMF to get the job done. For example, one biggie is desquamation, that weird word that describes how dead skin cells shed over time. These enzymes weaken the forces holding the corneocytes together, and they need water that NMF provides in order to shed. So where does NMF come from? It's formed by the breakdown of the protein filaggrin. The conversion of filaggrin to NMF occurs as the corneocytes move to the upper layers of the stratum corneum. Moving on up. The hydration levels of the skin play a big role in the production of NMF. If skin is too hydrated or not hydrated enough, NMF cannot form. What happens when filaggrin can't make NMF? You get skin conditions that suck. Many skin problems show a reduction in NMF and sometimes even an absence in filaggrin itself. Examples include atopic dermatitis, psoriasis, ichthyosis, and cirrhosis. That's a lot of osises. Notice something? All these conditions have trouble keeping moisture in the skin and show some level of scaling, flaking, or cracking. What's also interesting is that these conditions often have abnormal skin shedding. And if you want me to do a video that goes into more detail about that, then tell me in this poll right here. Frequent washing with soap has been shown to remove NMF from the top layers of the stratum corneum. So don't wash your hands. Kidding. Maybe. NMF can also be reduced through bathing, exposure to UV light, and aging. Okay, so I guess we're just supposed to stay away from the bath, keep indoors, and never get old. That doesn't sound like very practical advice. We better end it here. Thank you, Charles, for asking your question. Feel free to comment in the section below. Peace and hair grease, beauty heroes.